This is Saudi Arabia, a country in the Middle East where it occupies 4/5 of the peninsula. It is bounded by the Red Sea and the Persian Gulf, making Saudi Arabia the largest country in the Middle East, and strategically located as the crossroads of Europe, Asia, and Africa. With a total population of approximately 36 million and inhabiting a vast territory measuring 2,149,690 square kilometers. The people-to-land ratio, however, suggests a sparse distribution, accommodating a mere 17 individuals per square kilometer. This gives the nation an intriguingly low population density when compared to other countries. Consider, for example, Saudi Arabia's geographical size in relation to India. It amounts to about 65% of India's total area, yet the population density in India stands at a staggering 470 people per square kilometer, indicating a much denser populace compared to the Middle Eastern nation. In contrast, Saudi Arabia's land area is approximately 3.5 times larger than that of France. Despite this, France's population density is notably healthier, hosting just over 118 individuals per square kilometer. That would make Saudi Arabia among the least densely populated countries in the world. In fact, more than 95% of Saudi's residents are now settled in these areas, where 80% of them live in 10 major urban centers, like Riyadh, Jeddah, Mecca, Medina, Hofuf, Taif, Bereda, Kobar, Yanbu, Dharan, and Dammam. Some cities and oases have densities of more than 1,000 people per square kilometer, with over 6 million residing in the capital city of Riyadh and 2.8 million in Jeddah, 1.3 million in Mecca, and another 1.3 million in Medina. The rest of the population lives near or around these major areas. So what are the primary reasons why Saudi Arabia is so sparsely populated? And in what ways does Saudi Arabia's environment contribute to its low population density and vast stretches of uninhabited land? Well, one big reason is that a significant portion of the country is covered by desert. In fact, Saudi Arabia is considered 95% desert land, which can make it difficult to build infrastructure and access to resources. The Rub al Khali, or the Empty Quarter as it's widely known in Saudi Arabia, offers a fascinating study of geographical extremes. This immense desert, the largest contiguous sand desert on the globe, dominates the lower portion of the Arabian Peninsula, spreading its sandy fingers across four nations: Saudi Arabia, Yemen, Oman, and the United Arab Emirates. Its total area is an astonishing 650,000 square kilometers, dwarfing countries like France, Belgium, and the Netherlands when merged together. In this vast desert landscape, a journey from one edge to the other spans an impressive distance of approximately 1,000 kilometers or 620 miles in length, and 500 kilometers or 310 miles in breadth. The region's characteristically harsh and torrid climate can be especially taxing during the summer months, when the mercury can skyrocket to an intense 55 degrees Celsius or 131 degrees Fahrenheit. Interestingly, the Empty Quarter, despite its unforgiving conditions, receives more rainfall than certain other deserts globally. For example, the Atacama Desert in Chile, notorious as a rainless desert, supports barely any life due to its extreme dryness. When contrasted with the Atacama, the Empty Quarter seems rather hospitable, offering a compelling example of life's tenacity even in the harshest conditions. Its biodiversity is markedly limited, consisting of a mere 37 plant species. A closer look reveals that 20 species are scattered within the heart of this sandy wilderness, and the remaining 17 survive along the edges. This number might seem insignificant. However, their mere existence under such extreme conditions underscores life's enduring fortitude. Another factor contributing to Saudi Arabia's sparsely populated areas is that the country has one of the world's most scarce water supplies. With no permanent rivers or bodies of water, Saudi Arabia meets its water needs through a combination of seasonal streams, groundwater, desalinated seawater, and limited surface water availability. Saudi Arabia's freshwater resources have declined sharply over the past few decades. Until the 1980s, there were lakes at Layla Aflaj and deep water holes at Al Karj, fed by enormous ancient underground aquifers. Al Karj was a vital drinking water source in the barren landscape. In recent years, these non-renewable aquifers have been heavily drawn upon for agriculture and domestic use, and the lakes and pits no longer hold fresh water. With no permanent rivers or bodies of water, the country depends on desalinated seawater, scarce surface water, springs, and groundwater. Today, about 50% of Saudi Arabia's drinking water comes from desalination, about 40% from the mining of non-renewable groundwater, and only 10% from surface water in the mountainous southwest of the country. The capital, Riyadh, located in the center of the country, is supplied with desalinated water pumped from the Arabian Gulf over a distance of 467 kilometers. The third factor shaping the demographic distribution in Saudi Arabia is the presence of petroleum. The discovery of this critical resource has had significant implications, fundamentally shaping the population's layout across the country. In close proximity to Saudi Arabia, commercially viable reserves of oil had been previously identified in Iran, Iraq, and Bahrain. Even Saudi Arabia's founder, King Abdulaziz ibn Saud, based on these discoveries, was persuaded that his own kingdom potentially held untapped oil wealth. However, despite these discoveries being credited to British explorers, Ibn Saud harbored reservations towards their imperialistic and colonial inclinations. Instead, he turned to the Americans for assistance in discovering the oil treasures within his kingdom. In 1933, a mere year following the proclamation of his kingdom, Ibn Saud secured a contract with the American company Chevron. This agreement granted Chevron the exclusive right to undertake the search for oil within the kingdom. 5 years later, in 1938, this exploration bore fruit, with the first discovery of oil in Saudi Arabia. This pivotal find occurred at a site named Dammam No. 7, located near the Persian Gulf. As a result, Chevron established the Arabian American oil company Aramco to manage the newfound oil reserves. Over the years, the Saudi government gradually assumed full control over Aramco, rebranding it to Saudi Aramco, today's state-owned oil giant. As the oil industry rapidly increased, a need for a robust labor force arose. Unable to meet this demand domestically, Saudi Arabia opened its borders to foreign workers. Initially, the majority came from Arab nations, but the workforce demographics diversified over time with the addition of individuals from South Asia, Southeast Asia, and Africa. This immigration significantly recalibrated the country's population distribution, concentrating it in the industrial zones and major urban areas. Oil wealth brought with it the opportunity for vast infrastructure development. The Saudi government harnessed this wealth to build roads, hospitals, schools, and housing, making certain regions more appealing and livable. This again influenced the population distribution, with areas receiving substantial investment evolving into key population centers. In a nutshell, the discovery of oil in Saudi Arabia precipitated demographic shifts and urbanization, redefining the country's population distribution in a remarkable way.